Greetings from Pavlo Ardanov, Fulbright Research Scholar at the Agricultural Sustainability Institute, University of California, Davis, and co-founder of the NGO Permaculture in Ukraine. Welcome to the series of video lectures on designing crop polycultures, which is supported by the International Visegrad Fund. The topic of this lecture is polyculture system for orchards, and we review different design approaches, taking nut trees as an example. Under description to this video, you will find the links to different sections of this video lectures, as well as to slides where you can study spreadsheets on compatibility of different species for intercropping. Study of traditional multicropping systems is a good approach to design polycultures with predictable performance. For example, chestnuts has been traditionally intercropped with winter cereals such as oat and rye in soutos, traditional orchards in southeastern Galicia in Spain. Such high-yielding, low-input intercropping system increased fertility of upper soil horizons. Different chestnut species are often grown in pannage system for fattening pigs. Running poultry beneath the trees before and after nut harvesting can provide pest control. Polyculture may be designed based on marketing considerations. For example, with the aim of production of additional valuable products, such as edible truffle species, in multicropping sweet chestnut plantations, as this tree is adaptable to different environments and has multiple uses. Other tree species, such as oak, hazelnut, linden, and pine species, can be chosen as both truffle hosts and nut and timber producing trees, to be grouped with chestnut around the same market segments. Truffle, in its turn, stimulates development of tree root system, enhances water and nutrient uptake, and increases total plant biomass. Remodeling natural plant associations, or learning from nature and back to nature, is an example of agroforestry design approach that was implemented to develop viable agroforestry scenario for yellowhorn, a Chinese endemic oil woody plant. 18 species combinations were designed based on plant positive associations with yellowhorn in natural communities and anticipated economic benefit. These are medicinal plants, and two of them, which are marked with arrows, provide an additional benefit of nitrogen fixation. Successful agronomic systems can be adapted to different contexts. Here I present cover crop systems that was developed for pecan orchards in a cool temperate climate of Georgia, USA. But the same management and species selection principles may be applied to orchards in general. A presented system is aimed to provide permanent ground cover that does not interfere with harvesting in alleys, to reduce competition for water and suppress weeds under tree rows, to promote self-seeding and reduce mowing for ground cover vegetation, and to provide pest control. Cool season cover crops can be planted throughout pecan orchards. Three rows could be devoted to early maturing winter cover, which have mature seeds by the time pecan is in full leaf and compete little with the trees. And alleys could be planted with mixed winter annual cover crops, including later maturing plants. Many cool season legumes produce without tillage a good number of volunteer stands among worst season perennial cover crop and does not require reseeding. In spring and alternating 2 meter wide strips of cool season cover crops on alleys could be tilled in mid to late April or allowed to mature. The tillage strips would supply nitrogen to pecan trees immediately, while the adjoining untilled or receding strips could be mowed after seed is mature to ensure dispersal of seeds and re-establishment of cover crops over the entire alley. Rotary mowing of remnant strips could disperse seeds to tillage areas. Same strategy could be used with summer cover crops and with natural ground vegetation, which should be mown after leguminous plants have produced seeds. Otherwise, it will become dominated by weedy grasses. Mowing of alternate strips also ensure continuity of habitat for beneficial organisms. Warm season cover crops should be restricted to alleys to reduce possible competition for water with pecan, where they will also receive better illumination when trees are in leaf. Supplemental phosphorus can increase shade tolerance. Seeds of warm season legumes such as showy partridge pea and hairy indigo may be broadcasted. However, seeds of majority of legumes require drilling or disking for better establishment. Summer cover crops can include vining species, which will run into dead tree row strips over the dead mulch provided by winter cover crops to additionally limit weed growth under trees. Along with annual legumes, seed mixtures should include sod-forming warm season grasses that create grass carpet after mowing cover crops for easy nut harvesting. Additional mulching and weed suppression under trees can be achieved if cover crop residues are mowed from alleys into tree row strips, for example using side discharge mowers. Unmowed cover crop stands, for example of mature hairy vetch with rye, can also suppress warm season weeds, including perennial grasses, for several weeks into summer. The perennial warm season grasses are mowed closely during autumn. Under these conditions, most of the cool season cover crops of interest can be seeded by no-till drills or by broadcasting seeds and following superficial tillage. Since leguminous residues degrade more rapidly than grass residues, the warm season understory vegetation, which is rich in legumes, should be mown when at least some seeds will mature to combine aims of reseeding with the preparation of clean orchard floor for nut harvesting. Cool season cover crops can also provide alternative prey such as aphids and thrips that are not themselves pests of pecan and ensure reproduction and retention of lady beetles and other aphid predators in orchards until pecan aphids emerge in early May. At this time, winter cover crops usually senesce and pest predators can disperse to pecan. Ground cover plants can also sustain aphidophagous insects. Mowing or tillage of warm season cover crops may be needed to divert aphid predators from the cover crop to pecan trees at the prospective time of pest outbreak on pecan. Polyculture systems can be also constructed for allelopathic crops that suppress growth and development of neighboring plants. Walnuts, especially the black and Manchurian walnuts, are well known for their allelopathy, capacity to suppress neighboring plants, especially on poor shallow soils and in drought conditions. Suppressive compounds, juglones, primarily enter the soil through root exudation. Juglones are not very mobile in soil. They are absorbed by soil organic matter and rapidly decomposed by bacteria. Thus, most inhibition occurs in case of root contact with intercropped culture. At the same time, walnut has a number of traits beneficial for intercropping. In the spring, walnut is one of the last species to leaf out, and in the fall, one of the first to drop its leaves, reducing competition for sunlight with the winter crops. It also produces a large taproot and has a deep rooting system, leaving the top 10 cm of the soil horizon available for root growth of companion species. As it takes 10-20 years for walnut trees before they start producing economical yield of nuts or timber, intercropping under young trees is economically feasible. Young walnut trees also need protection, and it is feasible to interplant them with so-called nurse species, which protect the young walnut trees from mechanical damage and enhance the soil conditions. As for the timber tree species, red oak is not suppressed by black walnut, while many tree species, including white and red pine, white birch, American elm, sugar maple, and ash are suppressed by walnut. But this suppression occurs over time, and sensitive species can be used as temporary intercrop and nurse species. Autumn olive and black locust both improve black walnut growth, and autumn olive may reduce leaf spots and anthracnose because of associated microarthropods which consume the leaf litter carrying the disease. In addition, autumn olive is shorter than black walnut, and it prevents deers from damaging walnut trunks without overtropping and competing for sunlight with walnuts. Black locust, however, quickly grows tall and potentially compete with black walnuts trees via shading. During the first years, walnut grows deep taproot, while shoot growth is slow. Thus, full sun is available during the first 5-7 years, and fast-growing, juglan-sensitive plants can be interplanted. For example, alder may be planted for timber, nitrogen fixation, and for helping walnut to develop straight trunk. Alder may be gradually thinned between 4 years and 19 years after stand establishment to pay for the cost of establishing the black walnut stand. Soybean and wheat could be cultivated between the tree rows without yield decrease for the first 7 years, and corn for the first 10 years. Jerusalem artichoke, sugar beet, and certain species of beans are tolerant to juglans. Between 15 and 30 years of walnut establishment, shade and juglan-tolerant crops can be grown. Black raspberry, currants, elderberry, and wild grapes can be grown under walnut canopies, whereas blackberry outside of the grown area. Mulberry, pawpaw, and American persimmon are tolerant to black walnut. After 30 years, when walnut becomes shady and allelopathic, few ephemerals and late-ripening fruits may be interplanted to utilize sunny periods in walnut orchards in spring and fall, as well as American ginseng, shiitake, and oyster mushrooms, which benefit from shady and moist conditions in summer. Livestock is feasible to introduce after 15 years, when trees are large enough to withstand damage and does not need fencing. Heifers and hens benefit from partial shade under adolescent walnut stand. In video description below, you will find the links to slides as well as references and highlights to publications cited in this video lecture. Finally, I invite growers of tree, nut, and fruit crops, all growers with experience in crop diversification, researchers and agriculture extension specialists, to participate in one of the surveys listed on these slides. The links are also provided in description to this video. With your help, we will be able to develop free software to help farmers to design crop polycultures. We also invite you to subscribe to our Facebook page Polycultures and Permaculture, where we share useful information on crop polycultures from the academic publication and directly from growers. And we invite you to share your practical experience on this page. On our website, you will find recorded conference presentations, proceedings and resolution of the Research and Practice Conference Polycultures and Permaculture, which was organized in January-February 2020. Thank you very much for your attention.